Hello, I'm so glad to see you all again. Welcome back to the series about soldering irons and unique, out-of-the-box designs. Today, we're going to recycle an old glow plug and turn it into a simple yet effective 12E mini soldering iron, perfect for spot welding or working with light metals. No need to spend much money, just a few items lying around the house, and you can make it yourself. Let's get started. First, I'll remove its terminal cap. Secure it firmly so it doesn't move, then use a pair of pliers to twist and loosen the terminal cap until it comes off completely. Next, I need to drill out the inside so that later I can insert the soldering tip into it. You can find spark plugs at auto repair shops, car or motorcycle scrapyards, or even in old engines you no longer use. This is a steel bearing. Its hole fits perfectly with the spark plug. I'll secure it in place using hot glue, making sure it's firmly attached so it won't move during use. You can find this type of bearing at hardware stores, machinery repair shops, or salvage it from old tools, motors, or mechanical equipment you no longer use. Next, I have something very special, a magnet, which we'll use later to help hold small metal parts in place while working. Now, it's time to move on to the wiring, the heart of this DIY mini welder. I'll be using two flexible wires, one for positive and one for negative. First, I'll strip the ends of each wire. You can adjust the temperature yourself by changing the wiring or adding a resistor. It's super flexible for small welding tasks. Since this is a mini soldering iron, thick electrical wires aren't necessary. I'll use this type of wire, and it will work just fine. The key is to secure the connections and properly insulate the contact points to prevent electrical leakage. This setup will allow electric current to flow through the tip, just like in a real soldering iron. Insert the electrical wire through the hole in the spark plug. Take a solid piece of wood and shape it into a comfortable handle. This will not only provide insulation from the heat, but also make the soldering iron easier to grip and control. During use, drill a hole in the wooden handle so you can attach the soldering tip assembly securely, ensuring it fits snugly and stays firmly in place during operation. Now, attach the soldering tip assembly to the handle by inserting it into the drilled hole. Secure it in place with super glue, making sure the joint is strong and won't loosen during use. This will give the tool both stability and a solid, comfortable grip. Wrap electrical tape around the wire and the handle to hold them together securely, making sure the wire doesn't move or get pulled out during use. Cover the area evenly for a neat finish and provide extra insulation, which will also improve safety when operating the soldering iron. I've got quite a few old batteries lying around, perfect for experimenting with this mini welding setup. Instead of throwing away, I'm going to repurpose the inner core of the battery and turn it into a soldering tip, a clever way to give new life to old materials. Please watch the video until the end and let me know which method you like most. I look forward to hearing from you. I'll carefully extract the inner core from one of these old batteries. This core is usually made from conductive metal, and its size makes it perfect for precise soldering tasks. When doing this, it's important to be cautious, avoid touching any leaky material, and always work in a well-ventilated area. Once the casing is removed, I'll trim and shape the core. It's a great way to recycle and repurpose parts that would otherwise go to waste. Next, I'll grind the battery core to shape it into a fine soldering tip. This will help it heat up evenly and work more precisely. Now that it's been ground to the right shape, the core fits snugly into the spark plug. And just like that, we've turned it into a working soldering tip. To complete the wiring, I'll attach an alligator clip to the other end. It makes the connection quick, secure, and easy to attach when needed. That way, it's easy to connect and disconnect from both the power source and the device. The alligator clips act as flexible terminals. They grip tightly onto wires, battery terminals, or metal parts, making it easy to test and adjust connections during prototyping. Plus, they save time by eliminating the need for permanent joints. I'll add another wire to connect from a negative terminal. This will complete the circuit and allow current to flow properly through the soldering tip. For this wire, I'll attach alligator clips to both ends. For the power source, I'll be using a standard motorcycle battery. It's a 12V lead acid battery, powerful enough to heat up the soldering tip and stable for small electronics work. This type of battery is easy to find, rechargeable, and delivers consistent current, which makes it perfect for our DIY soldering project. Here, I have a broken phone holder, and I'm going to use this homemade soldering iron to fix it. Now it's time to put our DIY soldering tool to the test. I'll begin by trying to solder onto this razor blade, which is thin and metallic, making it a good challenge of tool. As I bring the soldering tip to the joint, the solder begins to melt and flow smoothly onto the razor blade and the strip wire. The tin spreads evenly, bonding the wire to the metal surface in a single shiny solder joint. After just a few seconds, it cools and solidifies. After soldering the two razor blades together, the joint feels surprisingly strong. Even when applying pressure or flexing slightly, the blades stay firmly connected without any signs of separation. The solder has bonded well to the thin metal surfaces, creating a solid bridge between them. Don't forget to like and subscribe for my channel. I'll heat the plastic until it starts to melt, then carefully press the two broken pieces together so the softened plastic fuses and bonds them into a single, solid part again. The phone holder, after being repaired, is now sturdy and fully functional again. The broken joint has been neatly fused back together. And finally, I'll use a paper clip to hold it in place while it cools and hardens. You can clearly see the effect of the magnet. It can hold the paper clip pieces securely without worrying about them falling off. And the movement of the adjustable parts remains smooth. Overall, it feels solid in the hand and is ready to serve its purpose just like when it was new, maybe even stronger than before. And that's it. From an old spark plug and a few simple materials lying around the house, we built a compact 12E mini soldering iron, and even put to the test by repairing a broken phone holder. It's proof that with a bit of creativity and some DIY spirit, you can turn scrap into useful tools while saving money and having fun in the process. If you enjoyed this project, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you won't miss any of my upcoming DIY ideas. And if you try making this soldering iron yourself, share your results in the comments. I'd love to see what you create.